So in the last class we went through the stationary wave and the calculation of NT node and nodes. If you remember, we will get NT node whenever we get even multiple of lambda by 4, and we will get node when we get odd multiple of lambda by 4. Okay. So if you have any doubt in the previous topic, kindly let me know now. Okay, raise your hand. Okay, I don't see any hand. That means you have went through the topic and there is no doubt. Okay. So the next topic is free and forced vibration. Okay, let us go through it. Page number 536. Okay, I hope everyone has the book in front of you. Free vibration. Every vibrating body has its own frequency. Yes, you will see. I hope you are already familiar with this tuning fork thing, right? This is a tuning fork, Y-shaped thing. Okay. Now. Every tuning fork will have a frequency written on it, 256 Hz, okay, or 512 Hz, like this it will be written on it. Now what is it? Hertz is the unit of frequency, as you know already, right? So that means the frequency of this one is fixed. Whenever you hit it, okay, when you hit it, it will start vibrating, right? And it will vibrate according to the frequency that is written on it, 256 Hz. That means in 1 second it will complete 256 vibration. This is what frequency is, right? Number of vibration completed in 1 second. Okay. So every particle, every body or every object has its own frequency. Everything. Not only this tuning fork, this marker also has its own frequency. If you hit it, you know, with something else, what will happen? It will start vibrating with its own frequency. Okay. Now, when a body is moved a bit by applying external force, it will vibrate with a fixed frequency. Yes, for that particular body, it is fixed. The frequency depends on the density, shape, and elasticity of the body. So, depending on the density, the frequency might change. Depending on the shape, it might change, and elasticity also is a factor to determine the frequency. Now, vibration of this type is called natural or free vibration. Okay, it is your own vibration. Nobody is forcing you, so it is natural. Natural or free vibration. Okay, let us go through the definition. The vibration of a body of any shape and size at a frequency is called its own or free vibration. Its own vibration or free vibration. Okay. The vibration of a simple pendulum is an example of free vibration. Okay. So I hope this is clear. Vibrating with own frequency. Okay. Now forced vibration. What is forced vibration? If a body is made to oscillate by applying a periodic force. Yes. Now let us think about this one. Let us say I have two markers. Both of them have their own frequency, right? Now let us say I have hit this marker and it started vibrating, right? Now as it started vibrating, now if I bring this marker, which was not vibrating, closer to this one, now what will happen? At first, this marker, which was not vibrating earlier, will try to vibrate with its own frequency, right? Because everyone tries to vibrate with its own frequency. But it will not be able to vibrate with its own frequency because now this one is vibrating under the influence of this one. Okay, see, this one is vibrating. If I bring it closer to this one, now they both will vibrate, right? And this one will start vibrating with the frequency of this one. Okay, this will be influenced by this one. Okay, so as you can see, I am forcing it to vibrate at the frequency of this marker. This cannot vibrate at its own frequency now. Okay, if it was vibrating with its own frequency, okay, then it is free vibration. But now I'm making it vibrate under this periodic force, that is the vibration of this one, right? So I am forcing it, I am imposing this vibration on this one. As a result, it is forced vibration. Daman, you want to say something? No. Okay, so now let us go through the definition. If you have got the idea, if a body is made to oscillate by applying a periodic force, yes, we are applying a periodic force from outside, right? The body first tries to oscillate with its natural frequency. This is what I just said, okay? At first, it will try to vibrate with its own frequency, but slowly it is observed that the body is oscillating with the frequency of the periodic force. Okay, so at first it will try to vibrate with its own frequency, but it will not be able to do that. So gradually it will adjust to the periodic force that has been applied on it, right? And it will start vibrating with the applied force frequency. Now, so as long as the periodic force is in action, the body will oscillate according to the frequency of the periodic force, whatever be its natural frequency. Yes. Okay, so as you saw, it was vibrating with its own natural frequency, and as soon as I brought closer to this one, okay, and made it attached with this marker, vibrating marker, what will happen? They both will now vibrate with the same frequency. Okay, so the oscillation of this type is called forced vibration. Okay, now go through the definition. If the frequency of an applied periodic frequency on a body is different from its natural frequency, the body will first oscillate irregularly. Yes. Now let us say this had a frequency of 512 Hz, this had a frequency with of 256 Hz. Now it is vibrating at 512 Hz frequency, and when I attach this one, this will try to vibrate at 256 Hz, which is its own frequency. But gradually it will adjust to the frequency of this one, and this will also start vibrating with 512 Hz. Okay, so for this one, which was vibrating, you know, naturally, for him it will be a natural vibration or free vibration. But for this one, which was not vibrating, but I made it attached with this one, and now it has started vibrating, for him it will be forced vibration. You understand this one, right? Okay. So here what we can see, the frequencies are different, right? Okay, this had one frequency and the frequency of this one is different. So at first there will be some irregular vibration, okay, but later it will adjust. So this is what they are writing. Okay, if the frequency of an applied periodic frequency on a body is different from its natural frequency, the body will first oscillate irregularly, then it oscillates with the frequency of the applied frequency. Okay, oscillation of this type is called forced vibration. So for forced vibration, what I can write, this is also, you know, vibrating with applied frequency. Okay, it will have its own and it will be some applied frequency. Okay, I hope the concept is clear. Okay, I will recommend you to go through this couple of paragraphs that are at the bottom of 536 page and at the beginning of 537 page. Okay, because I'm going to start discussing resonance. Resonance in Bangla it is called Dhununa. Okay, when resonance will take place. Now the the example that I gave you for forced vibration, you know, they are the markers at different vibration, different frequency, right? One had frequency of 256 Hz, another had 512 Hz, right? Now what if, you know, I am applying a frequency of 512 Hz, okay? Now this one also have the its own vibration is also 512 Hz. Now what will happen? Now they don't have to adjust, right? Okay, the body which was not vibrating earlier, it will not have to adjust now, because the vibration is same. Both of them will together now produce the vibration, right? So that time the resonance will be produced. So resonance is a special case of forced vibration, where the free vibration frequency is equal to the forced vibration frequency. You understand this one? Okay, now see, we will go through the paragraph. See, resonance. When a body is made to vibrate by application of external periodic force, and if the time period of the frequency of the applied force is different from the time period of the body, now we are considering at first, if it is different, then what will happen? Then the body will vibrate with very small amplitude. Yes, because they cannot match to each other. The vibration does not last long. Okay? Okay? Ripat raised hand. Ripat?
Sir, a resonance take to abar bujhaben.
Acha, did you tumi ki ei matro join korcho?
Na na, age thekei chilo, first e thekei achi.
Oi force vibration ta bujcho?
Ha ha ha, sob bujhi.
Acha, force vibration dui resonance ta bolo to. Force vibration e amader dui ta body chilo, tai na?
হ্যাঁ
একটা ভাইব্রেট হচ্ছিল, এটার ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি আমি বলছিলাম কত, 512 হার্টজ, আর আরেকটা যেটা ভাইব্রেশন হচ্ছিল না সেটার ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি বলছিলাম কত, 256 হার্টজ। তো এটা যখন 512 হার্টজে ভাইব্রেট করতেছে, এটার সাথে যদি আমি এটাকে অ্যাটাচ করি, এটার যদিও ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি হচ্ছে 256, যেহেতু এখন এটার সাথে অ্যাটাচ করে দিছি, এটা কিন্তু 512 হার্টজে কি করবে, ভাইব্রেট করা শুরু করবে,
তাই না?
একটু সমস্যা হবে না, বিকজ ও ফার্স্টে ট্রাই করবে যে ওর যে নিজের ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি সেটাতে ভাইব্রেট করা, কিন্তু পারবে না, ইরেগুলার একটা ভাইব্রেশন ক্রিয়েট হবে। ওকে, দেন গ্র্যাজুয়ালি ও অ্যাডজাস্ট করে নিবে এটার সাথে। নাও হোয়াট ইফ এইটারও ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি সেম, এটার ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি 512, এটারও ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি 512, কি বলছো বুঝতে পারছো? এখন আমি এটার এই যে যেটা ভাইব্রেট করতেছিল না সেটার উপরে যে ভাইব্রেশন যে ফ্রিকোয়েন্সিটা আমি অ্যাপ্লাই করতেছি সেই ফ্রিকোয়েন্সিটা হচ্ছে 512 হার্টজ, ওর নিজের ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি হচ্ছে 512 হার্টজ। তার মানে নিজের ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি এবং যে অ্যাপ্লাইড ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি দোনোটা যখন সেম হয় তখনই রেজোনেন্স প্রোডিউস হবে, কি বলছো বুঝতে পারছো? রেজোনেন্স ফোর্স ভাইব্রেশন, যেখানে ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি দোনোটা ইকুয়াল হবে। তাহলে জেনারেলি যেটা হয় যে ফোর্থ ভাইব্রেশনে ও নিজের যে ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি ওইটা আর অ্যাপ্লাইড যে ফ্রিকোয়েন্সি দুইটা ডিফারেন্ট হয়। ওকে, সো রেজোন্যান্স ইজ এ স্পেশাল কেস। ওকে, সো নাও সো বাট ইফ দ্য টাইম পিরিয়ডস অর ফ্রিকোয়েন্সিস অফ বোথ বিকাম ইকুয়াল, সি দে আর সেম, থার্ড লাইন অফ রেজোন্যান্স। But if the time periods or frequencies of both become equal, the amplitude of the vibration and its duration becomes large. Yes, both of them are, you know, it is like, you know, I can give you an example of two friends, okay? Let us say this is one boy and this is another of his friend, okay? Now, this person likes to play cricket, okay, very much. And this person, you know, likes some other game maybe, but not that much. So when this person becomes friend with this one, you know, he also starts playing cricket a little bit, right? Because he likes cricket very much. So this is something forced, right? Influenced by some other one. But what will happen if this one, you know, likes cricket and this one also likes cricket, that time what will happen? All the time they will be seen to be playing cricket, right? So now they are vibrating with the maximum, you know, vibration. Understood this one? This is the case of resonance actually. So, definition, if the natural frequency of a body is equal to the periodic frequency applied on it, the body starts to vibrate with maximum amplitude, right? Vibration of this type is called resonance, okay? So, for resonance, what I can write? Natural frequency is equal to applied frequency. This is the case of resonance. Okay, so I will go through the definition again. If the natural frequency of a body is equal to the periodic frequency applied on it, the body starts to vibrate with maximum amplitude, right? Because both of them are same. Vibration of this type is called resonance. Okay. Then they have given some example. Okay, I would like to recommend you to go through that examples, okay, and read up to, you know, page number 35 538, up to the intensity of wave. Okay, now before we move to the next topic, intensity of wave, I would like to show you a video, an example of what does it say, resonance. Okay, I will share my screen with you so that you can see it. I hope everyone can see my screen. I will try to look for the video. Oh. Wait, in YouTube I was trying to search, but I made a mistake. Okay. Takuma Bridge. Okay, see, I will give you an idea beforehand what happened here. Okay, now see, this bridge has its own frequency, right? Okay, and the air around it, the air flow, that the air that was flowing around it has its own frequency. Now what happened in this case is the frequency of the air became equal to the frequency of the bridge. See, the frequency of the air became equal to the frequency of the bridge, and that is why they produced a resonance, and as the result of resonance, they became to oscillate with the maximum amplitude. They began to oscillate with the maximum amplitude. I will show you now. The net is a bit slow. নতুন একটা সিম আসছে দেখা যাচ্ছে লাকি কেউ ট্রাই করছো না It was constructed, the construction of the bridge was started November 23, 1938, okay, and it was opened for traffic. That means the vehicle started moving through it from July 1, 1940, and it collapsed November 7, 1940, only a couple of months later, right? See what is happening. Start of resonance vibration of bridge in torsional mode, November 7, 1940, 10 a.m. Okay, just see this part, what is happening. Resonance, a very practical example. It is started to oscillate with a maximum amplitude. Little bit later, what will happen, you will see. This is not an edited video, okay, this is a real, you know, incident. Can you see there is a real car, collapse of center span. Now it will start to break down 11:10. Okay, at 10:10 it started, now at 11:10 it collapsed. It couldn't take the vibration anymore. only after a couple of months of being constructed, it collapsed due to resonance. Okay.
Sir, resonance actually কি এখনো বুঝিনি।
Resonance is when the natural frequency of a body equals the periodic frequency that is applied on it. Okay. Now this bridge has its own frequency, and the air around this bridge, you know, has its own frequency. Now both the frequency became equal. So what happened? They joined together, and the bridge started to oscillate with the maximum vibration.
So দুটো frequency add হয়েছে না?
Yes, when they match, you know, they produce the maximum amplitude.
Yes.
Okay. So this is what happens in case of resonance. Okay. If you search for more videos, you will get some more, and there are some, I guess, better videos, colored videos of this incident. If you want, you can go through that. Okay. Only 4 minutes left of this class. We have another class in the last period. Most probably, I will not be able to take that one today, but I will try. If not possible, then inshallah, I will try to take one class tomorrow. Okay. Monday, I have enough free period. So as I told you, Monday and Tuesday, if you can arrange an extra period for me. Okay. You said me that the Bangla class is not taking place. So you can just message me which period.
Now teacher takes class.
Teacher is taking class?
Teacher class. Yeah.
Okay. So, okay. Just check if you can arrange an extra period for me. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you everyone for joining, and go through the paragraph that I told you to go through. And if you have any doubt, inshallah, you can let me know in the next class or through WhatsApp. Okay. And must remember to inform me about your doubts regarding what is the previous chapter, structural properties of matter. Okay. Message me the doubts so that I can be prepared and discuss it in detail. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Assalamu
alaikum.
Alaikum, sir.